Well, it's taken 19 years, a life sentence and a quashed conviction. But today, the case against Jeffrey Gilham was finally closed.
He was spared a retrial by a vote of 2-1 and was acquitted of murdering his parents.
10's Ellie Southwood was in court today for the emotional scenes. Ellie, they were emotional indeed.
They certainly were, Sandra. And I think it took a little bit of time for everyone inside the court to fully process the judge's decision because they were split. But once everyone fully understood that Jeffrey Gilham had indeed been acquitted, there were tears, there was hugging, and I heard one man behind me sigh as he said, "It's over. It's finally over."
Jeffrey Gilham arrived at court on bail, facing the prospect of a third trial for murder. He left with his name cleared at last.
This has been a horrendous experience for us. I'm glad today that I've been acquitted of the charges, and I would just like to thank all the supporters that have stuck by me, most importantly, my wife Rebecca and my children, and everyone that's fought for the truth to be told. I am very happy to be going home a free man, and that's just all I want to do is go home.
His wife Rebecca struggled to hold back tears.
I'm just thrilled to be able to tell our girls that Daddy's never going back to prison.
For Jeffrey's friends, it was sheer relief.
Did you believe you'd get here?
Yes.
You never lost hope?
Never lost hope.
These friends have never stopped believing in him. They worked for years to build his appeal. Jill Gatland led the charge.
It has been a dreadful experience for Jeff and his family, and I think that they deserve to have some happiness in their life.
But the decision to acquit Jeffrey Gilham wasn't clear-cut. The judges disagreed.
We are not of one view with respect to the orders which should now be made.
The Chief Justice wanted a retrial, but the other two agreed to acquit, so the decision went their way 2-1. For Jeffrey's uncle Tony, who's long campaigned to have Jeffrey jailed, the decision was heartbreaking.
Has it been worth it?
Well, I've made his life hell for a while.
Tony Gilham says the DPP failed him, and now he wants an appeal to the High Court.
I'd like to say to him, it's not over yet.
This case has spanned almost 2 decades. First, Jeffrey Gilham was convicted of only the manslaughter of his brother, Christopher. Since then, he's become a suspect, a convicted double murderer, and an inmate. Tonight, though, he's back to being a free man.
Jeffrey Gilham has always sworn it was his brother, Christopher, who killed his parents.
Did you kill your mother and father? And your brother? You're saying that your brother has killed your mother and father? And I'm just wondering whether it's just a convenient ploy on your behalf to tell us that, when in fact you've killed the whole three of them.
When police took Jeffrey through the charred crime scene in 1993, he said he'd found Christopher standing over his parents' bodies. He picked up the knife his brother had dropped and in a fit of rage stabbed him to death.
And then I stabbed him there and he fell on the ground there and I think I kept stabbing him.
2 years later, Jeffrey pleaded guilty to his brother's manslaughter. He wasn't jailed, instead put on a good behaviour bond. But soon there were family disputes over his parents' estate, and with money seen as a motive, Jeffrey's uncle became suspicious and campaigned for the case to be reopened. He was sentenced to life in jail, but a team of family and friends never gave up hope. They worked tirelessly on an appeal, which went to court late last year. There, his legal team claimed they'd found fresh evidence. The arguments were so strong the judges quashed the convictions. Explain how I need to decide if he should be completely cleared. And now that 20...
The DPP now still can take this case to the High Court, but at this stage they haven't made any comment. But if they did elect to go ahead, the DPP would certainly have to weigh up with cost, and the time would be worth it.
Thank you. Ellie Southwood with that report.